Hi, this is Mohammed Khidr Kamran. Today I have created an chest infection detector. It tells that you have pneumonia or not. So let's open it. I'm going to explain you the code. I'm going to go to my C drive. Here is the folder. First of all, I'm going to run it. CMD Jupyter Notebook. This is made by many libraries. This is from Python with AI. If you know Python AI, this is best for you. I use here Keras and Tkinter and Certify, many libraries. And this is totally based on AI, Python with AI. So the program is predicting that you have pneumonia or not. We will give an X-ray report to the program, and that the program will tell us that we have pneumonia or not. Oh, I have imported warning here. After that, I warning dot filter warning, and I get bracket, and I write it ignore in inverted commas. After that, I write it TensorFlow import Keras. From TensorFlow, import the library Keras. After that, we imported some elements from Keras, for example, import lambda, then flatten. After that, we imported more things from Keras. We imported Keras.model. We imported model to use AI, DEU, Keras.application. We imported VGG16. We imported pre-process input. We imported image. We imported image data generator. We imported this library, and we imported NumPy SNP. After that, we imported globe. Next, we imported matplotlib. Then I have some folder. So there is a dataset. I got that dataset from website named Kaggle. So the data set is very large. You can see. So it is given a folder. It is normal X-ray images. It is pneumonia X-ray images. Validation folder is there too. So we give path of train path and valid path means dataset train and dataset test. After that, we make a variable named VGG, and we just call VGG16 and brackets input shape. After that, input in input shape variable, we wrote image size plus 3. We are giving here image size. Okay, weight we have given here IMAGENT, include top false. Here we are importing image. And first of all, I'm going to show you how our program will look. So if you will look at, you will have a better idea that what we will make. It's running. Okay, it's running. It will take 1 to 2 minutes to run because it's a large program. We use here Certify 2. If the X-ray report is normal, there will be a voice of artificial intelligence, a voice of Jarvis, that will say that the report is normal. If you have pneumonia, that voice will say you have pneumonia. Let's say upload image. We then go to dataset validation, and let's go first normal prediction. It will take 1 to 2 minutes to do. It's running. Wait. It says result is normal because we took the image from a normal folder. I think so you can't hear the voice of the Jarvis. If you run this code, you will hear. Let's go to another C chest x-ray, data set, validation, pneumonia. Let's take this picture, prediction. It says affected by pneumonia. And here's the image, GIF, you can see. So let's stop the code. Let's go. So after that, we input a layer. So a layer in VGD layer, not imported. After that, we can enable it to false. After that, we give folder variable and we use blob here. And we put bracket and give the dataset train path URL. You can see here is the train path in dataset. Dataset train path. After that, we put a variable in prediction and we used a layer named dense layer. We give the length of folder, here is the folders variable, and we use softbox activation. We make a variable of model and we just put model input vgg.input and outputs prediction. Prediction is the variable. We just click on model.sum. So it will run the code and it will be structured like that. It is running the dense layer. After that, we compile our model by model.compile. And we lost, our loss was categorical cost entropy. Our optimizer was Adam, and our metric was Acuity. Next, we imported Kera image data generator from Keras again. Next, we just find the folder that how many images we have. We make a variable named train data gen. After that, we imported, we wrote image data generator and we rescale it to 1.255. Share range 0.2, zoom range 0.2, and horizontal flip 2. We use test data gen and we wrote here image data generator and we scale it to 1.255. Okay. Next, we make us a training set and train dot data gen to flow from dictionary. We give the URL path of the train folder and we give the target size to 44 to 244. Best size 10 and class mode categorical. Test set, the test folder one, here we go. Here's the test folder and train. Test folder, we do the same. We give the test folder URL. We give the target size to 224, batch size 10, and class mode categorical. It says that class number 2 has this images and this has this images. So, if I go to test, there are two classes, Norman and Pneumonia. If I go to test, there are also two classes. So we added R and model.fit generator and we just training set and we make then training validation folder. Not validation folder, we create a validation variable which says test set. We run the HOs of one, check per approach length, training set and validation steps, length, test set. It will take many time. So it takes to 1 to 1.5 hours to run. After that, we imported TensorFlow STF and we saved our model as chestxray.h5. I can show you where is it, chestxray.h5. We imported many libraries. You can see we imported numpy 2 again and we load model our chest x-ray.h5. We load it again and we gave we wrote an image variable and image.loadImage and we give them URL of normal image. You can see data set. I think so we're gonna go to validation and normal. I took the URL from here and put double. We give the target size 224, great. So the coding is done. And after that, we gave x variable image.array. It will change our image to array, and we gave them image. X np.expand dims, and we give bracket x, comma x is 0. Image data pre-process input x variable. Classes model.predict, we give bracket image img data. It is predicting our model. And just we started the result and predicted. Result int classes 2, 0, 0, okay? And if result is equals to 0, person is affected by pneumonia as result is normal. We don't get result is normal. Why? Because we took a normal image from the folder. You can see we took here. So these are normal images. And after that, we imported Streamlit SST. It's important. So now we're going to make a GUI. So we import warning and all the libraries. You can see Qt widget and VQ movie. From these libraries, our folder explorer will open to choose an image. After that, we put an DESP that Jarvis. I have conducted a class on Jarvis. You can see that class on the GitHub. So I will upload it. So first of all, you have to know that what is speak function and how we will do. I made a function DESP SGR1, and I called speak by dispatch and sepi.sep. SP voice speak dot speak str1. Okay, now here we make a window from QMovie. The GIF will open. GIF is, you can see here, the main window. We resize, this, then geometry, style sheet, background color, widget, frame shape, frame shadow, set object name, Q widget, and set geometry, set text, Q movie, picture EIF. And in this whole code, we just do the work on GUI. Start object, and we do sizing here, and we put our GIF inside it. So our patient.png. It is not working on Jupyter, but else there would be an image of patient. So yeah, this was in this all code. Let me show you. In this all code, we used GUI. We designed our GUI. We named it. We put a GIF, and after that we put a button. We changed the button color and so on. After that, we make a function of this function is inside of class. This is returns a late UI. So main window, we are using here some HTML, CSS. After that, it will open the window, upload image. We will upload our image. And yes, by we have loaded the model chest x-ray, the dot file. You can see that from this to code, let me show you. From this to code, 1 minute. We can open our upload image by clicking here. This is opened by these two codes. After that, we predicted our result. And we can make a function DES. Then we gave an argument print result. Okay, if result is 0, 0 is bigger than 0.5, the result is normal. Then the Jarvis will say result is normal. S print affected by pneumonia, and there would be a voice of Jarvis, artificial voice, and it will say you are affected by pneumonia. And here's the coding. call this all we imported SAS, we make an variable of app, and so on. We make a variable of main window UI, UI dot setup UI, and main window dot show SYS dot exit app exec. So I hope you got it. Wait a second, I will run it again. You can see here the error. It is an optional error. It sometimes come or sometimes no. You will not bother in it. Wait a second, we will restart our program. There we go. Now the error is gone. But the window will open. Look, the window is open. Where is the error? There is no error here. We can upload image. Let's go to data set and we're going to go to validation. Let's do a picture of normal. Let's give it and let's do prediction. Wait. The URL of the index. Here we go. Result is normal. You took an image from normal folder. Let's go to, chest x-ray data set and validation pneumonia. Let's click on here. Prediction affected by the pneumonia. So this was my pneumonia detector, chest pneumonia detector. I hope you like it. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.